Hello, everybody. I'm sure you're wondering, where am I? Well, today I'm going to show you some examples of big problem solving, and hopefully this will help you out when doing the work for today. So I've got five different questions for you to complete. Let's start with the first one that we're going to complete together. So it's four times bracket 8 plus negative 3 bracket to the power of 2. Now, because the 2, the exponent, is outside of both brackets, it means that you must solve what's in the bracket first. So then we have our first line of problem solving. So we continue on with 4 times positive 8 plus negative 3 is positive 5 to the power of 2. Now, we did the bracket because embed mass brackets comes first. Next, we have to do exponent. 5 to the power of 2 is 5 times 5, so that equals 25. We bring down the 4 times. Now we have 4 times 25 equals 100. And there you have all the three lines that you are to show, which include showing your work and your final answer. Let's take a look at the next one. 6 minus negative 2 times negative 4 to the power of 2. There are no official brackets in this. The brackets in this are just to show you what your exponents are. So we must go to, what your integers are. So we must go to exponents. So then we have 6 minus negative 2 times negative 4 to the power of 2 would be negative 4 times negative 4. Two negatives multiplied together equal a positive, which would be 16. Positive 16. Then you might sit there and you might want to go 6 minus negative 2, but that would be incorrect because according to bed mass, you must do the negative 2 times 16 first. So then you would have 6 minus negative 2 times 16 is negative 32. 6 minus negative 32. Now let's remember what we know about subtraction. You have to add the opposite. So it would be 6 plus positive 32. Your answer would be positive 38. Next up, one that looks a little bit more difficult. Now, I want you to remember what I said about this division line. This division line acts as a bracket. This means you must solve what's on top first and what's on bottom first before you can divide the two. So we have negative 7 times negative 4 plus 2 to the power of 3. No brackets, so we start off with solving 2 to the power of 3. So we have negative 7 times negative 4 plus 2 to the power of 3 is 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8, all over. And this is where you can kind of solve another point at the same time. Negative 6 plus positive 15, we end up getting positive 9. Now you ask yourself, do we do the multiplication or the addition first? Well, obviously we do the multiplication, but a negative times a negative equals a positive, and then so forth, we have positive 28 plus 8 all over 9. And again, we have 36 over 9, which equals the answer is 4. Now, for those of you who are struggling with negative exponents, I have a couple examples here. Now, in order to use negative exponents, we actually essentially have to turn them into positive exponents. And the only way that we can do that is by either putting them into a fraction or into a decimal. In this case, we're going to turn them into a fraction. 2 to the power of negative 2 is actually equal to 1 over 2 to the power of 2, which is actually equal 1 over 4, okay? So then we can add that to 3, 1 over 3 to the power of 3. So 3 to the power of 3 is 27, 1 over 27.
Now, this becomes a simple fraction problem, finding your common denominator, making your equivalent fractions, and adding, and then taking to the lowest terms. Now, the next one I wanted to show you simply because you cannot minus exponents due to the fact that this is a division question, because these are two different bases. So you must do them as normally. So you would have 1 over 4 to the power of 3 divided by 1 over 2 to the power of 3. Solve your denominators. 1 over 64 divided by 1 over 8. You know that in order to divide fractions, you have to flip the reciprocal and multiply. So we have 1 over 64 times 8 over 1, which would then equal 8 over 64, which would equal 1 over 8. I didn't do this one because I don't have a calculator on me right now. Okay, I hope that solves things and sets you up for success today. Have a great day. Bye. Oh, if you have any questions, please email me.